Should I be drinking on my angry stomach? Probably not. Am I going to anyway? Yes.
Hi, editing Audra here. So for reasons, my internet is trash, thanks Spectrum. So this is gonna be an unusual Love is Blind video where you will see video game footage instead of me. It's my video game footage, so there's that. But enjoy, I guess. Who thought that Doom Eternal and Love is Blind Season 6 would go together? No one, but that's what you're getting. Thanks, bye.
But I just finished Love is Blind and I'm so sorry. I had to talk about it right this second because like I don't like it. Okay. Before, listen, it's made me very mad. I'm very upset. I don't like how it's gone. It's very, I can't. I'm quite upset. I don't like it. It's terrible. I swear on everything that is created. What is happening with this show? What is happening with my lighting? We don't know. Who cares? I'm gonna live my life. I'm a tech genius. I am not a tech genius. So first of all, petition to Netflix to please, for the love of all that is good and holy, I don't want that many pod episodes. I do not care. I don't know. Anyways, point is, I need them to stop having as many episodes about the pods. Because my mind exploded because I've blocked this out for the past 5 seasons that literally it's 4 weeks. Okay. So let me just tell you right now that if they mean like 4 weeks after the week that they're in the pods, still don't care, because if that means after a week, you are telling me that you love me, I'm leaving. I'm leaving immediately. I'm not staying. I'm like, oop, let me pack up my things and go. I know that makes me seem like toxic. Maybe I am, who cares? But I gotta go. Like, you can't love me after we've had a few superficial conversations about the fact that we both love the movie Labyrinth. Like, thank you. It is serial killer behavior. I'm sorry. If we're talking and she's like, oh, we both really love Labyrinth so much, and like we both think it's really cool that owls are like silent killers, like, I love you. No. No, you don't. Awkward. I feel like the most notable thing that happened in the pods was, I think her name is Jessica. Is her name Jessica? And her like losing her mind over bro not wanting her. And listen, this is where I'm gonna be a discriminatory person, and you can get mad at me if you want to, but I don't think that if you have kids, you should be on this show. I don't think so. I don't think so. I think that that's a weird thing to do. It's just my opinion. You know, and opinions are like buttholes and everybody has one, and that one's mine. I don't think that if you have children, you should be on Love is Blind. Because I look at it this way, if you were on Tinder, it would say that you have kids. And we all know, if like, or any dating website or a dating app. And we all know that on a dating app, if somebody says, like, if it says, do you have children? And they say, ask, we know that the answer is yes. And I don't want the complicated story that goes with it. Just say yes or no. Just as someone who used to date but doesn't anymore, like, just say yes or no, please, like, stop. I don't want the whole convoluted story about like how y'all co-parent and like blah blah blah, blah. I don't care. Do you or do you not have children? Because it don't say ask. That's a weird response. So in this environment, it is a weird thing to have to bring up immediately when you're trying to, because you're, I don't think that that works. I don't think that they should do that. Just my opinion. I also don't think it's good for the child later on down the line. Like, that kid has to go to school and stuff, and you are embarrassing. So I just don't feel this. Danny, exactly. Like, you tell me after a week that you love me, I'm like, why? Like, like today, me and my dog were having like dueling stomach noises. Like, mine would be like, whoa, whoa, whoa. And then his would be like, whoa. And then mine would be like, blah, 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 and then his would be like, whoa, whoa, whoa. This is what was happening for like an hour. We were laying on the couch. Like, that's how bad my stomach problems have been today. I just don't think that you shouldn't be on here. I don't want to be like a discriminatory a-hole, but I'm gonna have to be. I just don't think that you should have children being on Love is Blind. I just think that that's weird. Just like, it's a weird thing to drop on somebody and expect. And don't get me wrong, I don't like whatever his name is. Is it Jimmy? Is it, I don't, listen. I watched it. I watched all 6 episodes. But as some of you may know, and those of you who do not, I'm going to tell you, I am terrible with names. Terrible. And I will name you something that isn't your name, or I'll just call you that one girl. So, I... Thank you, Dark Angel, that part. I think kids are fine, but honestly, be ready to get rejected, same as divorce. And I think this is my problem with it, is she couldn't come right out the gate and say she has kids because she knew that that was gonna be a thing. And that's a thing for me. Like, if you have kids, I'm not interested, unless they're like out of your house and adults. I'm not interested, because like, I don't wanna be in that dynamic. I don't even like children. I've said that before, I don't even like children. So I don't even wanna be in the dynamic of like co-parenting and doing stuff for the kids. Like, no thank you, I'm good. I'm good, I don't want to. You can say whatever you want about me, I don't care. I don't wanna deal with any of that at all, period. I am very comfortable saying that to somebody. I have said it when I was dating. I have just straight up been like, yeah, no, I'm not interested. And they just, people got a little weird about it, being like, oh, you'd give up on a great opportunity, because I'm like, yes I would, because to me that's not a great opportunity. Do you see? To me, that's not fun for me. I don't want to do it. But Jimmy didn't even do anything wrong, and Jessica lost her mind, her ever loving mind.
You ruined this opportunity for me. You ruined it.
You ruined this opportunity for me. You ruined it.
Yelling at him, telling him that he ruined the entire experiment. Like, girl, what are you talking about?
Yep, you're totally right. If you need someone to hold your hand and guide you and coddle you, she will never be me. And she'll never be a woman like me.
What are you talking about? He's supposed to keep dating. He didn't tell you to stop dating. What is happening? So, of course, he ends up with Chelsea, who I feel like, did I mishear her? Because I don't think she said she looks like Megan Fox. I heard her say that she doesn't see it, and that other people say that she looks like Megan Fox, and she thinks it's because she has the dark hair and the light eyes. But she has repeatedly said, I don't see that.
I do too. All the time on the plane, I get one person. And it's just because I have dark hair and blue eyes.
And it's just because I have dark hair and blue eyes.
That's what Chelsea said. That's what I remember. She repeatedly said, I don't see it. Because, like, I know that I have an affinity for Aisha Tyler. But if you tell me that I look like Halle Berry, especially when I had a pixie cut, I don't accept that ever. Like, I never would. They'd be like, you look like Halle Berry. I'm like, I don't. And then people didn't know kind of what to do with that. They're like, oh, well, it's it. I'm like, I actually don't. We just have the same haircut, but I do not look like her. Just because she's the black celebrity you know doesn't mean that that's who I look like. So you could have just said I was pretty and left it there. But it is a humble brag. What's up, paper tape? How you living? Agreed. But I think she still brought up the Megan Fox thing as a flex. It's like a humble brag. Like, she looks like, listen, like long-faced Megan Fox. And that's not me being mean to her, because like, I have a ginormous forehead and I'm shaped like SpongeBob SquarePants. So a lot of the women on Love is Blind are giving me so much, like, I'm feeling better about my body, not body shaming them, but because I'm seeing more people have SpongeBob SquarePants bodies and it's making me feel good. I'm like, okay, this is the normal thing. The rectangular situation isn't just a me thing and I'm feeling good about it. Like, I'm happy about it because I am shaped like that. Like, I am triangular. Like, I'm not triangular, I'm rectangular. I'm like, whoop, just flat in the back, flat in the front. It's just like, it makes me feel good to see that there are people who look like me. I'm like, awesome. I'm not by myself in this. She looks like Megan Fox in the face if Megan Fox's face was longer. That's all. Like, that's all. I was happy about that. So that was like a whole thing. Jessica getting mad as shit, just being like, you ruined it for me. And I was just like, girl, I know you didn't. That happened. The other notable thing, Matthew.
100%. You're going to be judged is always a little bit, you know, scary. However, I think also being in like, you know, everyday life, people judge too, you know?
Netflix, can we have a conversation about background checks?
Superman had a cold personality to start off to.
I think his name is Matthew, and I feel like this was some kind of psychopathy that I wasn't expecting here. Where are they finding these like weird, not diagnosed narcissists to be on this show? Where are they finding them? Because the way that Matthew, I thought him and AD were gonna be so cute.
Give me a little more time, and I think maybe I can win you over, or maybe somebody else.
Is that something you want to do, win me over?
I'm going to try.
Oh. Okay.
And then he just like, a tornado of like, it was like whiplash. And then the way that he tried to let her down was like, it was her fault. Like, you want the ring and I'm not going to be able to give you that. And I'm like,
you know, America, they do love a good underdog, and they do love comebacks.
He, oh my gosh, sociopath. Like, this behavior.
I think I now got the entire country of America on my side.
Was unhinged, and I was just sitting there the whole time. Because, like, I was rooting them on. I was like, oh my God, this is going to be so cute. Like, we're going to have, like, a cute little, like, IR thing happening here. Like, ooh. And then he was just like,
I just don't like the way that you sound today. I don't think you really want to do it with me.
What? You're telling everybody the same thing. You're being weird. Like, this is too much. Listen, I'm convinced the questionnaire they give contestants is something out of the DSM-5. I agree. Because that stuff that was going on in the pods was a little wild. And I still don't like it. I think his name is Clay with AD. I just feel like AD deserves better than all of that, but we'll see.
I think you're an amazing person, but it's not fair to you that I can't commit to the plan that you want.
So then the main thing that I really wanted to talk about, to me, because like I said, I feel like the pod episodes go on too long. Like they're just trying to like drum up all this drama. Also, y'all, listen. What minute are we? We're at 17:49. I'm free to say this. Vanessa Lachey's titties. Can we talk? Because, baby, I was no better than a man. She's standing there talking. I was like, girl, I'm gonna put my face in them. I'm sorry. Listen, I apologize. But they were so... I didn't even know. I couldn't even see if her makeup was good because I was just like, oh Lord, like Nick Lachey is over there looking like a Cabbage Patch Kid. And Vanessa, like, I don't even know why she's still married. Like, listen, I guess, whatever. But like, he's getting like, cause his eyes are getting all beady and going back and further into his skull. And she is getting finer and finer, like finer and finer. Okay. Does she cause problems at the reunions? Yes. Is she a shitster? You're damn right. But she is banging and I listen, the way that she wears all those Vita and like, in one of them, they were like, the areolas were holding on for dear life inside of that dress. I was like, you remember that D'Angelo video? The singer, how does it feel? Where we were all looking down the screen, hoping to get a peek at it. Listen, it was a weird time. I felt like that watching, like when she's standing there talking, like trying to see if I would see him. Like, am I gonna see him? So anyways, but then we get to the honeymoon and this is the engagement moon, as I've affectionately coined it, engagement moon TM. This is where things always start to go wrong. And can we just talk about Jeremy? I know it's Jeremy, but he spells it Jeremy, and that's how what I'm going to call him. Now, I'm going to be honest with you. I like Jeremy. I find him endearing because I, too, am a child. So I find his childish antics and behavior to be nice. Like, I would enjoy that. Like, if I was on Love is Blind right now and had to pick, after all of these episodes, who I would be partnered up with in the hetero world, it would be Jeremy.
I do have a stud finder.
Okay.
You know how you test the stud finder?
Boop. Okay, because that's my vibe. Matches my vibe. Making fart noises on my face. Yes, you know, jumps into the pool, has a good time.
Stop!
I'm there for it. Fun, you know, fun guy. I knew immediately that Blondie was not gonna be nice. She is mean. She is mean. She was mean to him from day, like she was not being nice. Although I am gonna say that the scene where they're like, when they first showed them laying on the bed, I did have a little difficulty telling their legs apart because he has like smallish legs, which is fine. There's nothing wrong with that, I have small legs. But like their legs were intertwined, and I guess because he's like kind of blondish, his leg hair was like blondish. And I was like, oh, she doesn't shave her legs. You know what I mean? But there's nothing wrong with that. I don't shave my legs most of the time. You know, I shave them in the summer, not in the winter. You know, I need to be more aerodynamic in the summer, but like in the winter, I need to be as furry as possible because I'm working in the cold. So like, that's where we are. Non-toxic nerd. He's gonna like hug you, but also give you space. He seems fun. Like, why is she so mean to him? I don't know what her name is. I'm calling her Blondie because she's blonde. Mean.
Is this my life now?
Listen, as soon as you said that to me, I literally would have looked at her and been like, it doesn't have to be. I like dead to her face. It doesn't have to be because, girl, I don't have to put up with all this. I do not have to put up with all this. I am fun. I am joyful. I'm fun to be around. You are a pill. You are a pill. Like, you're just like a pill. It's just a mess. I was like, no. No, girl, don't, no. Why are you being mean? Like, I couldn't figure out why she was being so mean to him, and I didn't like it. I was like, stop being mean. That's not gonna last because she's hateful, and when you're hateful, relationships don't last. Like, that's why you're single. Like a lot of these people, I'm just like, yeah, I can see why you're single. You're mean and you're hateful and you belittle other people. There was a whole thing that happened about bean slapping.
She's taught me about, what is it, bean dip?
But basically it's titty slapping.
She set me up. She was trying to set me up for some bullshit.
Really? Bean dip is like this titty smack. Like a fucking titty smack. She smacked the shit out of my titties.
I'm not sure why you would say something like that to your fiance and then not ensure that he doesn't repeat it. I don't get that. Like, girl, you literally, all you had to do was just like not repeat that shit. Like tell him like, oh, I'm telling you this in confidence, but don't repeat it. And to me, it was just weird that she was like, I don't care, I'm gonna repeat it. I was like, maybe not. Maybe not, maybe don't repeat it. Maybe just don't. Maybe you can live your life in a way where you're not repeating that kind of stuff. You should just tell, like, you should have made it very clear that he didn't need to say that to anyone. Since you didn't, he didn't know what it was. And on top of that, when you said that about bean slapping or titty slapping AD, and he repeated it to her, when AD came to you, you got defensive, nasty, ugly about the whole thing.
Trying to make something out of nothing.
I mean, what the fuck? Like,
I made a simple ass joke.
I think it's funny to us, but like, obviously to Clay, he's like,
like, not to fucking funny. Relax.
Hold on, not relax, because telling another man to.
Yeah, but as a fucking joke.
Well, and he, like, doesn't know Jeremy's the joke. In the wrong. He doesn't know
the joke. Well, Jeremy's in the wrong if we've been bringing it up, because it was a literal joke.
He doesn't know the joke, though.
Yeah.
So.
You did not validate her feelings. You did not acknowledge that maybe you should not have said that. You just were nasty. And I don't like that at all. Like, girl, that's gross. Like, you, when AD's like confronting you about it, you're like, it was just a joke. It's just a joke. Like, don't do that. Don't, all you had to do was go, you know what? I know it was a joke between us. I shouldn't have shared that with him. That was a mistake on my part. And I thought that he would have the sense to not share it in a public space. But that's also still my fault because I didn't explain to him that that was just like a private joke. And I apologize for bringing our girl private joke to my relationship in a way that embarrassed you in front of your man. I just didn't understand that. I didn't understand why she couldn't just admit that she made a mistake. And also, I'm just gonna quickly have a small conversation about why this, there's a whole scene, and I don't know if they did it this way on purpose, but it looked and felt very much the way it always does when a beautiful Black woman, beautiful dark-skinned Black woman is in a space with a lot of white women getting any sort of attention from a white man. The way three of those women got in a corner and started being weird.
Can I do another tequila soda, please? Thank you so much.
Want to come say hi, obviously.
Not the way I wouldn't come say
great.
Hi.
You're fine.
Chelsea has nothing but good things to say about you.
Love her, yeah.
Yeah, and I love Clay. Are you happy with everything?
Yeah.
About Jimmy talking to AD, nothing was happening there, in my opinion. They were just like chatting it up, talking about their significant others, talking about how things were going, and immediately Chelsea just starts her like victim falling apart, and then two other women come to her rescue. AD hasn't done a thing except be banging, all right? But nothing is happening. And instead of you like curling inward on yourself and making things weird and being like, I feel sick, you could have just walked over and gotten into the conversation. Like, I don't understand this whole subtext, this whole weird bullshit that you did, where you just like crawled under, like just sunk into yourself. And then I'm not understanding why your friends allowed that, because that's not what I'm gonna allow my friends to do. Like, if I'm there and I'm your friend, I'm like, girl, what are you doing over here being like, I feel sick, like that? Go over there and talk to your man. What are you even doing? If you're that worried about it, go have a conversation. Because the thing is, if she had gone over there, she would have found out they were talking about like their relationships and how they were happy. Like, that's the whole point of this mixer, aside from us viewers getting to see it as drama. But like, that's the whole point of this mixer. You're over here shrinking and trying to get all of this attention because you're insecure, and your insecurities are your insecurities. But babes, I'm telling you, like, I'm so confused why you are trying to find love with all of these insecurities, and you're just throwing them onto everybody else. Like, everybody else has to deal with your insecurities. It's just unnecessary. I could not put up with her. I would throw hands. I would quite literally throw hands with her. I'm the kind of friend that's gonna slap sense into you, literally. So if I'm your friend and you're over there like, oh, I feel sick, I can't, oh, I'm going to slap you. And we'll be like, girl, get it together. And we're at the point now where I have to slap you, because obviously you have left your brain somewhere. It's not here. And I'm just trying to slap it back into you because I'm so confused. This man proposed to you, y'all are together. And then we're gonna come back to angry Blondie and Jerami in a minute, but then you go into the room with said man.
You all right?
Mm-hmm. What's wrong?
Good. I'm good.
What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong.
The whining.
If you're uncomfortable, I'm sorry you're uncomfortable.
It was just very odd.
There wasn't anything like flirty. There wasn't anything you wouldn't have wanted to hear. If you were a part of that conversation, you would have known all that.
It made me feel icky.
I would have left from the whining alone. I would have like packed up my shit, been like, girl, we're too old for this. You're over here whining about shit. You're comparing us to the other couples.
All the girls
talked about how great their connections were and like how
I bragged about you all night.
Absolutely not. She's sitting in there whining, moaning, bitching and complaining. Oh, we're not being lovey-dovey. They were just as lovey-dovey as everybody else. They really were. It's just like the second he like got out of her orbit and spoke to literally anyone that wasn't her, she was like,
I felt so disconnected from you tonight. It was so strange for me. It was odd.
She is the most insecure I've ever seen. Like, I've never seen someone be, the last time I saw someone be this insecure was, what's her face? Xanib. Xanib is the last time I saw someone be this insecure. And I still don't like Xanib, I don't care. But like this was, and here's what really, I mean, I over the edge, I got over the edge because here's where things went super wonky, okay? She's whining about, oh, you know, we could, all the other couples are doing, he's like, I didn't think I had, and he's basically like, girl, I didn't think I had to be up your ass because I thought we were secure and comfortable with each other. I thought that's where we were.
I just felt really confident about where we were and the connection we have to the point where I didn't have to be by your side all night. So I'm sorry.
And obviously, you're not there. I am. You aren't. And she just continues to cry. And then he does acknowledge her feelings.
Fine, I don't need you by my side, but like, that's why this is very sad to me because like, it was just a very...
How is this sad? This is like going out with our friends and you know where I stand. Like, I'm the luckiest person. I'm the happiest person here. I'm sorry you feel that way, but...
Thank you. Thank you for acknowledging how I felt. I didn't feel loved by you.
She says, thank you for acknowledging my feelings. And then proceeds to keep throwing a tantrum.
I feel like you're questioning that I love you.
Melting down. Okay, what do you want me to do? This is making me mad. Okay, I'm telling you that my feelings were hurt. You said hurtful comments. You made me feel uncomfy.
Okay.
So just take it.
I would have been like, girl, I just said I love you. I acknowledge your feelings. You acknowledge that I acknowledge them. Why are we still fighting? Because I should still be able to tell you how I feel. This isn't a one-way street. You don't get to bitch at me and use me as your punching bag because you are insecure. And then when I tell you how I feel, you tell me I just have to take it. Girl, pack your bags, get up. To the left, everything you own in a box to the left. Get out. We haven't even, like, I'm immediately done. I don't know how these people put up with it. I don't care about contracts. I would be gone. I would literally out the door. I'm not doing that. We are not doing that. It's not gonna happen, loves. It's not. I'm not gonna do it. I would like, listen, it would have taken everything I have not to just pack up my shit and be like, anyways, I'm gonna go enjoy the rest of this honeymoon without you. I'm gonna have fun. Let me know when you have grown up and got it together and we can have an adult conversation. Until then, I'll be in this other room. I'm gonna be drinking some wine, some champagne. I'm gonna chill with the boys. We're gonna have a nice time, but I'm not doing any of this. I'm not gonna do any of this. Cause she acted like, because she was hurt, he needed to like, I mean, all he did was assuage her. Assuage everything that he could. Pacified, accepted that he hurt her, apologized for doing so, and she just wouldn't let it go. Girl, get out of my face. Goodbye. So now we've got to go back to Blondie and Jerami, okay? Once it gets back to Blondie, and once she realizes the faux pas of the inside joke, and she refuses to even acknowledge to AD that that was not okay, and AD, you can literally see her calming herself to not be the ABW. And Jerami comes over, he sits down, and then he's just starting to realize, like, I want to go home. Because even the other men are like, she's a firecracker. And there are two ways that men say firecracker when they're referring to a woman. There's, she's a firecracker, which is exciting. They're like, yeah. And then there's, she's a firecracker, which is not good. Which is not good. And they had the low They didn't have the up voice firecracker. They had the down voice firecracker. Because they were like, this shit is wild. And he's just like, you know what? I want to go home. And she's like, what, like to the room or like to your home?
Are you
ready to go home?
What? Like home or back to the hotel?
No, I'm ready to go home.
And I was like, I would too. If somebody had treated me the way that she treated me, I would want to go home as well. You've done nothing. Like, and I don't know why she doesn't see that. I'm like, girl, you've done nothing but belittle Jerami since we've gotten here.
Oh, you guys are over here talking shit.
We love it.
We love you.
You're talking shit. I'm going to have words with you later.
Great. I love that for me.
Like, you have not been very nice to him almost the entire time. Like, he's over here like, 10 out of 10. I'm having a great time. You're wonderful. This is fantastic. And you're like, eh. Also, can we just have like a quick, like, bow our heads for Jeremy, for Trevor's, whatever he's using on his scalp, prayers, right? Prayers. Because I don't know what's happening here, but you have to stop using whatever that is on your scalp. Use something nicer to your head, because it's, I want you to live a great life. You seem like a super nice guy. And I don't know what you're using. I don't know what you're using on your scalp, sir, but it is leaving. He's a white guy. It's leaving like a red rash. You seem really nice. I just use whatever it is that you're using that's making your scalp mad. Just like back up off of it. That's all I'm saying. Use something that's kinder and sweeter to your scalp. I think that they need to infuse Love is Blind with a little bit of that ultimatum sauce. Here's what I'm proposing. I think that what they need to do is have the engagement moon. First, all the couples meet, right? They're like, la, 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 la. And they're there for a couple days. And then they invite all the rest of the people that they all dated, all right? And then everybody mingles and gets to know one another and see each other. All that jazz. And then you have to decide if you're gonna stay engaged to the person that you got engaged with in the pods, or if you're gonna take a chance on love with somebody else that you dated that you maybe should have picked. Because I feel like Chelsea, first of all, should never have picked Jimmy. She should have gone with Trevor. Trevor the mullet guy. She should have gone with him. They were a much better match. She should have gone with him. They would have been happy together. I feel like she was so eager, and this is the problem with too many of the women on this show, in my opinion, is that they're more interested in securing the bag, the wedding, the ring and all of that, than they are in choosing the partner that's right for them. Like, I think she was worried that Trevor was going to potentially choose somebody else. So she, like, and this is, again, insecurity. She was worried he was potentially going to choose somebody else. So she was like, well, I'm going to go with this sure thing. Like, girl, don't be doing all that. Matthew can burn in hell, obviously. Because what you're seeing is once everybody, like, gets to know each other, they have to do this, like, fake thing where they're pretending that they're really happy with the person, but they're not. And you can clearly see it in a lot of people's body language. Like, you can very clearly see just in, like, if you're looking at the couples when they're all at their own, like, they all had individual private pools in their hotel room, right? So when you're looking at the pool with Laura and Jerami, there's obviously friction there from that very moment. The friction starts when they're in the bed and he's like being playful and cute. He goes on her face or whatever, which is cute and funny. I thought it was cute. And they're just not, so they're spending all their time like breast implants, far away from each other, but up. And so, you can clearly see that they're not gelling with one another. And he's realizing, like, I think I picked the wrong woman because, like, this woman does not like me. Like, she doesn't, and I thought that she didn't like him from when, is it me? Or when she saw him and fell to the ground, like, I didn't think that was like, oh my God, I like him so much, he's so cute. I felt like she was like, oh, this is not what I was looking for. I thought he was cute. I think he's cute. I like my little nerds, you know? I like my little geeks.
Same.
Hi. You are handsome.
I thought he was handsome and kind and clean. His feet were clean and they didn't have those weird calluses on the bottom that a lot of men have because they're gross and they refuse to lotion their bodies. Like, he looks like his skin is taken care of. Looks like he washes his face and his ass. You know, I don't know about Trevor. You know, I know he has his mullet, but I don't know if he'd be, you know, I don't know if he gets up in there. I don't know if he does like a full through there, but Jeromey looks like he's cleaning himself regularly. I didn't feel like Jimmy and Chelsea's body language was working because his, to me, and this is just like, this isn't body language, I can say blah, blah. I'm talking about these two together and their body language towards each other. I'm not a body language expert. I'm just saying that from what I'm looking at, he is very into and she is very like uncertain a lot. She's very like away from and kind of like, so, you know, I don't know. I didn't feel that attraction. Like, obviously Clay and AD are into each other. I do not like Clay. I'm just gonna keep saying I don't like him.
I wouldn't even let you get like out of shape.
Yeah, but what if I do get like?
I'll tell you.
I don't know. I don't know why, but I feel like, I'm feeling.
I'm like, AD, get in that motherfucking gym.
You would not talk to me like that.
I would say, if you were out of shape, I would tell you.
That way, though?
You will be determined to go if I said it that way.
Be nice.
You don't think I'm nice?
I don't think that was nice. I don't think being like, you need to get in the gym is nice.
Like, why doesn't he know about wedding bands? Certainly he's seen someone get married. And I don't know why I decided it's a red flag. It just is. He was like, does the man get a ring? Brother. I'm concerned that you don't know this stuff. It's making me uncomfortable. I'm like, it makes me feel weird. So far, and the redheaded gentleman, whom I also love, don't know his name. Red wavy hair, thick as a tree stump. Like, he got thick legs, red and wavy hair, and the girl he's with, who is also very beautiful, but like, they're just kind of boring right now because they're really into each other and they seem well suited. And she is absolutely beautiful. I like her soft vamp look. That's what I like to call it, the soft vamp. She's got like just the beautiful liner, but it's like minimal vampy. Gorgeous, gorgeous. Those two are doing well. I think they're fine. They're like really into each other. They've got the like, they've got the curves into one another where they're actually enjoying spending time with each other. I think, you know, Clay and AD do like each other. I just don't feel, I'm worried he's going to be a disappointment in the end. And I hate seeing black women get embarrassed on this show. That's all. See, Selena. I watched enough to know I don't care for Clay either. Yeah. I don't. There's just something about him that's giving me like, you know, I'm keeping one eye on him. But like, at the end of all of this, here's what I feel like we're going to see a lot of musical chairs happening with these couples. I think from what I've seen on the previews for coming up, I think Chelsea is going to take her little ass back on over to Trevor. Okay. Jeromey's going to get with another girl because Lara's a bitch. She is just, she's mean. And it doesn't matter who she's being. She's just mean. She's acting like a hunt with a C and I don't like it. Like, girl, you need to learn to be kind to people. There's no reason for that. Amy and Johnny. Okay. So like, I feel like that's what's gonna happen. I feel like these are my predictions, is that we're gonna have some musical couples happening. And we have the black gentleman with Britney. I don't remember his name either. And it's really weird that he keeps trying to say that he's never been with a white woman before because, sir, I don't believe you. I don't believe you. I don't believe him. He's like, this is the first time I've ever been with a white woman before. I'm like, I don't think that that's true, sir. Why are you lying? Why are you telling lies, Kenneth? I'm like, Kenneth, why are you in these streets being a liar? Hi, Alex. I don't believe him. Everything about him says I date white women exclusively. Like, I don't know how else to explain it, but if you're black, you know. Everything about him says, like the fountain, whites only. Like, everything about him says that. He's got dreads, so we can't really see his hairline, but he's giving, I only date white women.
How's it going, Larry? I love you. Tell him that. So, yeah. Bro, you got a queen on whole boss out here.
He's giving that energy.
You typically like date white girls?
Don't. She's a first.
Really?
She's a first. She's a first.
How's that going?
Never in my life. Like, it has superseded my expectations.
Really?
So when I saw her, of course, I was like,
banging.
Beautiful.
Body, yep. Face, everything, yep.
He was giving that energy from jump, and I don't, I'm just looking at it. Every day he's like, this is the first time I've dated a white woman. I'm like, sir, why are you lying to us? And they're not going to, I don't think that they're going to be good together. I don't think that they're going to be good together because, you know, this is very much the definition. And I'm not saying Britney's a pick me. What I am saying, though, is that the argument that people have for pick me's is why don't pick me's and kings just get together? You know, the men who are like, we were kings. Why don't they just get together? And this is why. You're already seeing it because she is ready to follow his lead and follow his direction. And he doesn't like that it's just so easy. He wants her to put up a fight and be feisty so that he can break her. I know that sounds very SAE. Or like I'm talking about horses, but that is what he wants. He doesn't like that she's being so agreeable. He can't handle it. He's like, no, she's being super agreeable. I don't like it. That's why that very argument, watch that argument people always have, like, why don't the pick me's and these, why don't they get together? And this is why they're not there. It's not. Yeah. Kiara wants to humble women and he's not happy if he's not humbling. We'll see how that goes. Which, by the way, Britney is so pretty without makeup. I don't know why people keep saying Jessica is so hot and so gorgeous and he's gonna be like, Jimmy's gonna be gagged when he sees her, because I feel like she looks like every girl I've ever seen on Instagram. And I think that Britney is just like naturally beautiful. I love that she was like, my favorite part of my day is taking off my makeup, because I was like, girl, me too. Like, I love putting it on, but I also love to take it off. Like, it's one of my favorite. I watched Kenny JD's commentary and I also cringed a little when she talked about being submissive and deferring all parenting decisions to him. Ask your dad. But if that's what makes her happy. Yeah, if that's what makes her happy, you know, I want her to be happy and have that kind of relationship she wants. But I think that the kind of men who say that that's what they want in a partner, they don't want it from somebody who wants to give that to them. They want to take it. They want to train you. And she's already trained. You know, I'm like, girl, you might want to consider getting into the BDSM world, because maybe you will find one for you. Get you a daddy dom, girl. Get you a good daddy dom, girl. You will defer all decisions to him. And they don't all make you call them daddy. They don't all make you do that. You could call him sir. Anyways, so out of the women, I like AD. I like Britney. And I like Amy and Johnny. I like Amy. So it's Amy, AD, and Brittany. That's who I like. Chelsea can kick rocks. I can't stand her. I can't stand her whining. And her insecurities. Like, your insecurities are not my problem. I've said this a million times. If you get into a relationship and you're insecure about things, you can explain those insecurities to somebody, but it's still your responsibility as the person with the insecurities to figure out how to deal with them so that it doesn't negatively impact your relationship. That's how that works. If you've been cheated on before and you have insecurities about being cheated on, you still have to do that work. You can't expect the other person to completely change their life around to fix and help you with your insecurities. Because at some point, listen, if that's me, I'm gonna be like, girl, I'm so sorry, but I had to cheat on you because you made me. And she'd be like, what? I'd be like, here's the thing. You were freaking me out so bad. You know, I had to give you, like, there had to be a reason why you were actually mad. Like, you were just mad at nothing. So I apologize, but it's too late. You did this to yourself. This is why I'm toxic, okay? This is why I'm toxic. This is also why I'm hot. This is why I'm hot. So yeah, I'd be like, girl, nah, like I can't. And what's funny about Amy is Alex, you said, because I've never seen them do this before, but this is the funniest thing that I've ever seen. So Alex said, I like her too. As a Latina, I did consider the possibility of Johnny fetishizing that she's a Latina, but he seems okay for now. Yeah, he does seem okay. But the thing that was funny is she was like, I never would have picked him. And then she goes, because normally I like darker skinned men. I almost fell off the couch. I almost rolled off of the couch. There was something so funny about her saying that. And then I think feel like they panned, like, you know, did a shot of him like sitting there just white as can be. And I was... I was almost finished. I almost passed out because I was like, not her just being like, normally I like my men dark. He's not that. I would never, if I was in a club, I would not have picked him out of the lineup. I would have just kept walking by. But he's different for me. I will take him. But the way, listen, I think that they did this along with all of the food that they were insisting on showing, like, look, everybody's eating. We have food. They have food and drinks. They're trying to beat these rumors for lawsuits. They're really, Netflix is trying to beat these. They're like, we are Emmy nominated and the people here get food to eat. I think that had Chelsea had any brains in her insecure head, she would have stopped for a second and gone for what she really wanted and stopped worrying that Trevor might not pick her. And this is again why I think that they should infuse it with that like swap at the end. Like, do you want to stay with this person or start the live-in process with a different person? Because oftentimes now, people are so afraid of not getting proposed to that they make the wrong decisions. You know, they choose the wrong person. We saw that with Zach and Bliss. They like think they start getting into their head too much. And like Zach made a decision because he swore, because listen, you know, we all know that Bliss sounds like this. And she's like, oh my God, like it's so good. And like, I sound like such a nerd. And she doesn't, like, if you heard this voice, you're not going to think to yourself, like the person on the other end is fine as fuck. You're just not. You're not going to be like, oh my God, so fine. That's not going to happen in your brain. You're not going to be like, oh my God, when you hear this voice, this isn't the voice of like hot as fuck, you know? So he was aware of that. And he was concerned that he wouldn't be physically attracted to Bliss. And then he met Bliss in person and was like, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. He met her in person and realized, like, because, you know, obviously Irina was just a dumpster fire of a person. And he got out of that and he went and met Bliss. And then that's when he came to the realization that like he should have gone with his gut instinct, which was Bliss, you know? And that's part of the problem with Love is Blind is that it really isn't. And I think that to really, cause like to do a real experiment, cause they keep being like, ugh, but you have to have a double blind part of this experiment because you can have people who met in the pods and stayed in the pods. And those people are like, yes, Love is Blind. We met through here. Even after meeting everybody, we still knew that we were together. But you can also have people who are like, well, initially I felt like it does work. Love is blind because initially this is the person I had the contact with, but for reasons I made different choices. And then once I saw them in person, our souls still met, like our souls still connected, and we realized that we had made the wrong choices and now we're together. So love is like semi-blind. And I feel like that would make it, one, more interesting, and two, it would kind of make people like less weird. I need Netflix to let go of having like the first basically 4 or 5 episodes be the pods. None of us need that much of the pods. The pods is becoming so boring. It's reaching the stage where I'm just like, I don't need all of this. And I feel like they're like milking drama that isn't there. And I don't care what anybody says, Jessica's speech was a flop. I know people thought it was fire. It really wasn't fire. Like, girl, you threw a tantrum because, you know, you're apparently a hot IRL and he should know that before having let you go. That's a weird thing to say.
When you see and realize what you missed out on, you are going to choke. You're gonna choke. You are going to need your EpiPen to open up your airways because you are going to be in disbelief of what you missed out on.
I think that on first listen, you might find it fire, but if you go back, and you might still think it's fire. We can all have differing opinions. I thought it was a flop the first time I heard it. I was like, this girl is out of her mind. Like, are you okay? Do not come around here talking shit to me like that. Thank y'all for joining me this evening to talk shit about Love is Blind, because I do love having conversations with y'all. It's always a good time. Y'all make me feel seen. Give me some joy. Until next time, you know what I'm about to say. I am so pretty and so are you. Bye, y'all. Enjoy your evening.